year, a record 5 million visas will be issued to foreign students, tourists and workers, with many of them choosing to call Australia home for good. The unprecedented boom is being likened to the influx that Australia experienced in the aftermath of World War II. Weekend Today reporter Jessica Tancred has taken a look at what it means for our future and why it's largely good news.
We are one, and we sure are many. And this year will be 5 million more, thanks to a record number of visas set to be handed out by the Department of Immigration.
Well, the 5 million short-term arrivals are great news for anyone in the tourist sector and anyone in the education sector. You know, these sectors are two of our biggest export earners. They keep the economy going. And so to have more tourists coming and more students here, that's fantastic.
A whopping 1.9 million foreigners will be in the country at any one time.
Adding an extra 2 million people, even short term, is of course significant.
The number of permanent migrants coming into the country will also break records. This year's intake surpassing the existing record of 185,000 set back in 1969.
If you just look at permanent arrivals coming into Australia and staying for 12 months or more, we're talking about the equivalent population of a new Gold Coast every 15 months.
The number of Chinese-born Aussies has tripled to almost 450,000 in just two decades. Those born in India has risen more than four times to 400,000, compared to 6,000 Kiwis. But taking the cake, the 1.2 million Brits who now call Australia home. A trend Mark McCrindle says is a sign we're connecting with our neighbours.
In fact, six of the top 10 countries of permanent arrivals are in Asia, so we're more connected to our part of the world, and that's certainly a big change from the focus on Europe that we had a few decades ago.
And their preferred place of residence, our capital city.
The way we really grow in Australia has been by growing our existing cities, our existing population centres, by expanding those.
Migrant hotspots in Sydney include Billabood, Cabramatta, Harris Park, Hurstville and Lakemba. In Melbourne, Springvale, Laverton, St Albans and Sunshine. In Adelaide, Einfeld, Virginia, Blair and Athol. In Perth, Bentley, Dianella and Canning Vale. And in Brisbane, Robertson, Callum Vale and Stretton.
We need to make sure the investment is there in the cities, because that's where the permanent arrivals are going to be, that's where the students study, that's where the tourists go.
Mark doesn't believe the influx is any threat to jobs.
Largely, the skilled visa program is employing people who are working in fields that Australians aren't working in or there's a shortage in, so it'd be great to think that it's not actually taking jobs away from those looking for jobs.
Immigration lawyer Anne O'Donoghue says short-term working visas contribute to economic growth.
These people are coming in, they're paying taxes at a higher tax rate, they're consuming goods, and it is a benefit to the economy, as well as the benefit to the employer.
Global media baron Rupert Murdoch is urging us all to embrace a big Australia.
It is the collective self-interest to welcome immigrants, those who cherish the values of the country and who are sometimes willing to risk all in the quest for a better life.
But others are less enthusiastic. The most vocal, former Australian of the Year and entrepreneur, Dick Smith.
Right now we should be making decisions on population. We should have the best brains working out what could happen if we do go to 45 million or indeed 100 million, and what advantages we could have by perhaps keeping the population at 23 or 24 million.
And with existing infrastructure already stretched to its limits, Mark says there's no sign of slowing.
Well, we're going to finish this year at 24 million. That's a new milestone. Next year, Sydney will hit 5 million. We know based on the current growth trends that we're going to hit about 40 million people by the middle of this century. And that's just based on the current growth that we're seeing. So that's a lot of new people to make sure that we can house, and again, to make sure that the quality of life is maintained.